Welcome, shoppers. We here at your local pharmacy would like to stick as many people as possible with a giant needle, and our pharmacists are glad to do it with a big smile. So if you're between the ages of who gives a shit, stop in and let's set you that shot so we can meet our numbers goal. Oh, and to make sure you're protected this season. Come on down. No appointment needed. We're right next to the meat department. We'll be smiling and waiting to stick you. Thank you.
Welcome to Druggy Nation. We're the bridge between everything pharmacy and pop culture. And now, let's check in with your connect and America's favorite pharmacist, Emmanuel Wogirin.
Hey. I'm going to keep saying hey this entire episode, and y'all going to stick around and love it too. Hey. Is he gonna stop? Hey, no, I'm playing. Shout out to everybody listening. Hope everyone had a great holiday season and a great start to the new year. Shout out to everybody still going strong with the New Year's resolution. I'd like to welcome everyone listening to the first episode of Small Doses. It's my new experiment, and I want to try it out and definitely hope to hear back from you guys about what you think. So let me explain a little bit about what Small Doses is. So along with dropping my regular half-hour podcast, we're also going to drop a 15-minute shorter podcast called Small Doses. Now with this one, I can talk about other relevant pharmacy news, and also we can focus on a particular condition like allergies or new drugs or cold and flu season, for example. Maybe I'll also tell you guys some stories I may or may not have heard as a pharmacy intern that may or may not involve me allegedly. So stay tuned, and I'll keep you guys up to date on all the latest pharmacy news. So today, since we're right smack dab in the middle of the season, I want to talk about cold and flu. Now, if you haven't gotten a flu shot already, go get one. That's just the pharmacist in me speaking. If you don't want to, that's cool. Just stay away from me, all right? I don't know if it's a surprise or not, but a lot of people don't know the difference between a cold and a flu. And since we're just about entering cold and flu season, let's talk about the difference. I'll start with some common questions and misnomers I get in the pharmacy. I get like, what is the difference between a cold and a flu? Which medications is most likely to cure a cold? What is pseudoephedrine? Why is it sold behind the counter? When might you need a prescription drug to treat the flu? Also, like, how does chicken soup make someone with a cold feel better? So I'm going to try and answer all those questions within this episode. So I get a scenario a lot in my pharmacy where someone will come up to me and say that they think that they had the flu and then proceed to describe that they really feel the symptoms of a cold. So to help the public and get some clarification, I'm going to break it all down. And I think it's important for us to know and understand this. And you know, maybe my listeners can let their families and close friends know the difference while giving my podcast a shout out. It's important to know the difference between the flu and cold symptoms. First, let's state the obvious. A cold is not as bad as the flu. While cold symptoms can make you feel bad for a few days, flu symptoms can make you feel bad for days to weeks. Now, the flu can also lead to serious health problems such as pneumonia, and you can end up in the hospital. What are some common cold symptoms? Cold symptoms usually begin with a sore throat, while usually goes away after a day or two. You can get a runny nose, and then you get congestion, and then a cough by the fourth and fifth days. Maybe a slight fever for adults, but that's more common in children having a cold with a fever. In terms of mucus, you start off with your mucus being watery at first, then it becomes darker and thicker, but that doesn't mean you have a bacterial sinus infection. It's just the cold's progression. How long do cold symptoms last? So cold symptoms usually last for about a week. During the first 3 days that you have cold symptoms, you are contagious. That means you can pass the cold to others. So stay home, because nobody wants that, and get some much needed rest. If cold symptoms do not seem to be improving after a week, you may have a bacterial infection, which just means you need antibiotics. Sometimes you might mistake cold symptoms for allergies or sinus infection. If cold symptoms begin quickly and improve after a week, then it's usually a cold, not allergies. But if the cold isn't getting better after a week, check in with your doctor, because it could be an allergy or a sinus infection. Okay, so that's the cold. Now let's talk a little bit about the flu. What are some common flu symptoms? Flu symptoms are usually more severe than cold symptoms and come on quickly. You can have sore throat, you can have fever, headache, muscle aches and soreness, congestion, and cough. And if you're lucky enough to get the swine flu, you can have vomiting and diarrhea to that list. Most flu symptoms gradually improve over 2 to 5 days, but it's not uncommon to feel run down for a week or more. A common complication of the flu is pneumonia, particularly in the young, elderly, or people with lung or heart problems. So if you notice shortness of breath, let your doctor know. Another common sign of pneumonia is fever that comes back after having been gone for a day or two. And just like cold viruses, flu viruses enter your body through the nose, eyes, or mouth. So you want to wash your hands with soap and water. Avoid touching your nose and mouth with unwashed hands. And stay away from those sick people because they decided to be nasty. Okay, so just to sum it all up, give you a little spark nose version, a table comparison version. So I'm going to go over cold and flu and go over symptoms and see which is most likely to have which, okay? So first, let's start with the cold. So let's say symptom fever. So the cold, sometimes, but it's usually mild. In terms of fever with the flu, it's usual. Higher between 100 to 102 degrees Fahrenheit. It's occasionally higher, especially in young children, and lasts 3 to 4 days. Symptom headache. For the cold, it's occasional, but for the flu, it's common. Symptom general aches and pains. For the cold, slightly you can have that. For the flu, it's definitely usually and it's often severe. Symptom for fatigue, weakness. For the cold, it's sometimes. For the flu, it's usual, can last 2 to 3 weeks. In terms of extreme exhaustion, for the cold, you never really get that. But for the flu, it's usual and it's at the beginning of the illness. In terms of stuffy nose, for the cold, it's pretty common. And for the flu, you get it sometimes. Another symptom, we have sneezing. For the cold, it's usually, and for the flu, it's sometimes. In terms of sore throat, for the flu, sometimes. For the cold, it's definitely common. In terms of chest discomfort and cough, for the cold, it's usually mild to moderate. You get a hacking cough. But for the flu, it's pretty common. It can become severe. Everything's just more severe with the flu. In terms of complications, with the cold, you get some sinus congestion and some middle ear infection. For the flu, you get sinusitis, you get bronchitis, ear infection, pneumonia, which can be definitely life-threatening. So definitely a lot more complications with the flu. In terms of prevention for the cold, you want to wash your hands often and avoid close contact with anyone with a cold. And in terms of prevention for the flu, you also want to wash your hands often and avoid close contact with anyone who has flu symptoms and also get the annual flu vaccine. In terms of treatment for the cold, we have decongestants, we got pain relievers, fever reducers, different kinds of medications for that. In terms of flu, we have decongestants and pain relievers, fever reducers, all available over the counter, cough medicines as well. But those cough medicines and cold medicines should not be given to young children. You want to get a prescription from the kid's doctor and definitely call your doctor for more information about any kind of treatment for the flu. Now, I went over a bunch of stuff for the cold, but let's go over some cold remedies that actually work. You want to stay hydrated, definitely, you know, water, juice, a clear broth, or warm lemon water with honey helps loosen congestion and prevents dehydration. Definitely want to avoid alcohol, coffee, caffeinated sodas, which can make dehydration worse. You want to rest because your body needs to heal, definitely. For any sore throat, you want to try a salt water gargle, like a quarter to half a teaspoon of salt dissolved in an 8-ounce glass of warm water, and that can temporarily relieve a sore throat or a scratchy throat. For stuffiness, you have over-the-counter saline nasal drops and sprays that can help relieve the stuffiness and congestion. For pain, for kids 6 months or younger, you can give only acetaminophen. For children older than 6 months, you gotta give either acetaminophen or ibuprofen, but definitely ask your child's doctor for the correct dose for your child's age and weight. And lastly, you wanna sip warm liquids. So a cold remedy used in many cultures is taking in warm liquids, such as chicken soup. I mentioned that earlier as a question. So chicken soup, what it does is loosens congestion and prevents dehydration. So it's definitely really good. Now, for some cold remedies that don't work, antibiotics don't work, because again, right, a cold is a virus, not a bacterial infection. So that doesn't work. And some cold remedies that have conflicting evidence, because they haven't been studied enough, is vitamin C, echinacea, there's not enough evidence to support that, and also zinc, there's not enough evidence to support that too. So, but all in all, to just get over a cold, just take care of yourself. You know, colds can make you feel miserable, but definitely just rest and drink fluids. And just keep the air around you moist. And remember to wash your hands frequently and you'll be all right. All right, let's switch it up. So now I want to get into some pharmacy news I thought was interesting. So out in Denver, guys, magic mushrooms could be decriminalized. And that could be voted on by this spring, 2019. So it's a group pushing for the decriminalization of magic mushrooms, and say they might have enough signatures to put it on the ballot this spring, which is wild. So there's a campaign to make Denver the first city to decriminalize psychedelic mushrooms, okay, in May. So this campaign is called Decriminalize Denver, and they need like 8,000 signatures to the election office for them to have it on the ballot and people to vote for it. Now, the reason, the proposal would be to deprioritize enforcing penalties on adults age 21 and over who possess or use psilocybin mushrooms, known as magic mushrooms. And it would bar the use of any city funds to impose criminal penalties on any adults using or possessing the drugs that would designate magic mushrooms as the lowest law enforcement priority in Denver. So, psilocybin mushrooms, right, are characterized as Schedule 1 drugs by the federal government. Schedule 1 drugs, which include heroin and ecstasy, are drugs the government says have no medicinal value and a high potential for abuse. So definitely keep an eye on this and on Denver, because if this goes through, then a similar thing could be happening in Oregon, but that's not till like 2020. But Denver could be the first to decriminalize the use of magic mushrooms, which would be major. So that's it, guys. That's the first mini episode of Small Doses 2019. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys like this smaller, shorter, informative episodes, let me know. Leave a comment. Like I said, it's on social media. You can find me on Instagram, Emmanuel_Wogerin. That's Emmanuel_Wogerin. Also, like and follow my Facebook page. It's Drug E Nation. That's DRUG-E Nation. It's on Facebook. So go ahead and like and follow the page. You can get all my episodes on iTunes, on Spotify, Google Play, SoundCloud, Stitchers, everywhere you listen to podcasts. And while you're there, guys, please subscribe to iTunes and Spotify. And let me know what you want to hear in my next podcast episodes. Shout out to Soulja Boy. Shout out to all my druggies. Soulja Boy, tell them I'm out.